So a lot of you asked about eggs and cholesterol. There's a lot of confusion around eggs, so in this video, we're gonna focus only on whether they raise our blood cholesterol levels or not. If you have other questions, let me know. Everybody knows eggs have a lot of cholesterol, but does that mean eating them raises my cholesterol levels? That's a different question. Just because a food has a lot of a certain nutrient doesn't necessarily mean that it ends up in my bloodstream. We have to test it directly. Scientists asked college students to eat a large egg every day for 3 weeks. Those poor college students are always the guinea pig. After the experiment, they ended up with higher LDL cholesterol. That's the bad cholesterol, although I don't really agree with those nicknames. We cover that in this video. Okay, but maybe the students didn't follow the instructions, or maybe they ate some other junk that raised their cholesterol levels. Who knows? You can't trust those college students. So we need to confirm. What if we could give people eggs and then swap them in and out without them even knowing it? Impossible? Some nifty scientists figured out how to do it. They gave people egg or egg substitute. Indistinguishable taste, but 4 times less cholesterol. Start people off with eggs for 4 weeks, their blood cholesterol level shoots up. Switch them to the substitute, their cholesterol drops. Do the experiment the other way around. Start them off with the egg substitute for 4 weeks, cholesterol goes down a bit from their baseline, switch to real eggs, cholesterol shoots up. And that's double blind. So the volunteers didn't really know if they were eating the real eggs or not, and even the experimenters didn't know until the end of the experiment when everything got analyzed. We've also had confirmation in massive analyses of large numbers of rigorous studies that eating more cholesterol tends to raise our blood cholesterol levels. Okay, so if there's this much evidence, how is this such a controversial topic? Normally, these confusing ideas about food floating around on the internet that have people pulling their hair out, they're not plucked out of thin air, because that wouldn't stick. They're usually rooted on a nugget of truth. So what's the nugget? The nugget is that the effect of food on our cholesterol level depends on context. If your cholesterol levels are low, the more cholesterol you eat, everything else being equal, the higher your blood cholesterol level will tend to go. But as you get to higher blood levels, the effect peters out. This is true of many other physiological parameters. It's not specific to cholesterol. Our blood pressure doesn't keep going up infinitely in a perfectly straight line as we eat more and more salt. Our blood sugar, etc. There's usually a ceiling effect at high levels. Okay, so now that we understand this dynamic, we're in a position to understand where the confusion comes from. Let's play a game called Science Twister. Let's say I want to prove that eating eggs does not affect my blood cholesterol levels. How can I design the experiment to get that result? Pause the video if you want to think. We're going to go right into the answers. There's actually several ways to twist things and win this game. The most obvious one is to stick to this range. Take someone who already eats a lot of cholesterol, typical Western diet, and who already has high blood cholesterol levels, and ask if adding a little bit more in their diet makes a difference. Probably not. Another way to twist it is to compare the eggs to another food that also raises our blood cholesterol levels, like red meat or butter, something with a lot of saturated fat. This is why the reductionism is so confusing, focusing on single nutrients. My blood cholesterol is affected by the cholesterol I eat, sure, but also by the saturated fat I eat, the unsaturated fats, the fiber, etc. So always be wary of confusion around isolated nutrients out of context. Here's another strategy to win at Science Twister. This one is like the ultimate, like the Jedi level mastery. These researchers acknowledge that LDL cholesterol goes up with eggs, but they argue that's fine, because HDL cholesterol also goes up. Except that if you saw our LDL and HDL video, you might remember that study after study has shown that raising HDL cholesterol levels doesn't really affect heart disease risk. So this argument that one makes up for the other, that they compensate for each other, is not compelling. Okay, so eggs raise our cholesterol levels in general. There's some context and some nuance. Fine. What we want is the bottom line. Is it okay to eat eggs or not? Here's an example. Individual A is in good health, good body weight, great cholesterol levels, and he or she eats an egg here and there because he likes it. Individual B has lipids that are out of whack, high cholesterol, and eats 5 eggs every day because he thinks he needs the protein. Clearly, this is night and day. The first case, I don't see a problem, and the second case could do a lot better. Now, admittedly, these are extreme cases. A lot of people are going to be somewhere in the middle, but you get the idea. These dietary decisions factor in our health, our lipids, our family history, our personal preferences. So are eggs good or bad? Depends what you compare them to and your circumstances. Eggs are not necessary, and they're not this magical protein source that we can't do without. So if you'd rather not eat eggs, that's completely fine. But it's also not true that if your diet includes some eggs, that it's automatically unhealthy. Can they be a problem in certain contexts? Sure. We just saw case B, where that person is unnecessarily jacking up their lipids. But we also saw case A that was very different. There's this tendency online to oversimplify everything. Everything, every food has to be good or bad. Everything is turned into a soundbite. And it just confuses people. Every time I do a video on a given food and I go over the results and I try to explain areas of nuance, somebody will pop up in the comments and say that I'm an industry shill because I'm not outright blanket condemning the food or I'm fence sitting for views or money. We're so used to food being classified in soundbites that unless we say the food is perfect or evil, we must have some agenda. Personally, I avoid eggs. I don't think they would add anything to my diet, but that doesn't mean we're going to make stuff up. At the end of the day, it's less about specific foods and more about overall dietary pattern. A diet high in saturated fat and cholesterol will tend to raise your blood cholesterol levels, with or without eggs. And conversely, a diet high in fiber and unsaturated plant fats will have the opposite effect, even if you sometimes eat eggs. Now, people often ask about egg whites. We have a lot less evidence on those, but yeah, in all likelihood, they won't raise your cholesterol as much because the fat and cholesterol fraction is missing. That said, in my experience, when people ask about egg whites, it's often coming from a place of believing that we need massive amounts of protein and that it's really hard to find. And so we need very specific protein sources like eggs to get all the protein we need. And for the vast majority of us, that's not true at all. Protein is everywhere, and most people in the West are already getting all the protein they need, and then some. So if you eat some egg whites here and there because you enjoy them and you're a healthy person, I don't see an issue. But if you're slamming egg whites with abandon as a staple source of protein because you're stressing out about not getting enough protein, chances are you really don't need to. We have this protein fixation in our society that's way off and not really conducive to optimal health. In this video, we look at LDL, HDL, and what it all means. And this one looks at protein, where to find it, best sources, and how easy it is to get all the protein we need.